بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد صادق الوعد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان ودعا بدعوتهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد Respected brothers and sisters in Islam السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Allah the Almighty says in the Holy Quran والفجر وليال عشر وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَدْ I swear by the dawn, by 10 nights, and by the even and the odd. The Mufassir of the Holy Quran, حَبْرُ الْأُمَّةِ Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhuma explains the meaning of وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ by 10 nights are the first 10 days of the Hijjah. And by the meaning of even and odd, by even, Allah means that يَوْمُ النَّحْرِ, the 10th day of the Hijjah. And by odd, He means the 9th day, which is Yawmul Arafah, or Yawmul Arafah, the day of Arafah. What we need to listen to here is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He first taken an oath of the 10 nights, then specifically He mentioned the day of Arafah after that. In another verse, Allah the Exalted says in Surah Al-Buruj, وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ And I swear by the witnessing day and by the witness day. Shahid, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, the meaning of Shahid here is for Friday, because when the Prophet of Allah did the Hajj, the Yawm al-Arafah was on a Friday. And Mashhud means Yawm al-Arafah, because it is witnessed by all the angels. So when we look at the Qur'an, when we study the Qur'an, you see the significance of the day of Arafah mentioned in the Holy Qur'an in various verses. Two of the verses that I have just translated in front of you. Remember, brothers and sisters, this was the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen to announce the entire ummah that the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is completed. Imam Bukhari narrates that a man came to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an. He was a Jew. And he said, Amirul Mu'mineen, ayatun fi kitabikum, law nazalat alayna ma'ashar al-yahud, lattakhadnaha a'ida. There is a verse in the Holy Quran. If this verse was revealed to us, the Jews, we would have made this day the day of celebration. Umar ibn Khattab said, Ayu ayah, which verse? He said, قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى The saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا Today I have perfected for you your religion. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي And I have completed my favors upon you. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا And I am pleased for you, I am pleased with Islam as a religion for you. Umar ibn Khattab said, that verse, والله إني أعرف أين نزلت ومتى نزلت لقد نزلت على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم الجمعة وهو بعرفة I know exactly when the verse was revealed, where the verse was revealed. This verse was revealed when the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was in Arafah on the day of and the day was Friday. So it's a double celebration. Friday is the day of celebration. Arafah is the day of celebration because the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-Hajj Arafah, Hajj is Arafah," in meaning that if a person misses Arafah, then nothing will compensate him missing this Arafah. No matter how many animals he or she slaughtered, he needs to come back again because Al-Hajj Arafah, because Hajj is Arafah. So when someone stands in Arafah, someone comes in the plain of Arafah at the time of Arafah, yes, then his Hajj is accepted. And a good deed is done. So that's a day of celebration. So he's saying that the verse was revealed at a time when we were celebrating. It was a Friday. It's a day of Eid. And Arafah is also a day of Eid for the Muslim Ummah. This is the day, respected brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He forgives millions and millions of people. Subhanallah. Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala and Imam Bayhaqi transmitted that مَا رُؤْيَ شَيْطَانُ يَوْمًا هُوَ فِيهِ أَصْغَرُ وَلَا أَدْحَرُ وَلَا أَحْقَرُ وَلَا أَغْيَضُ مِنْهُ فِي يَوْمِ عَرَفَ The shaitan was never seen on a day in which he is more humiliated, repulsive, and despised, and angry than the day of Arafah. Because he sees that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving so many people. Rahmatullah, the mercy of Allah is descending. Tajawuzillahi anil dunubil idham. And Allah is forgiving many grave sins. Wa innahu layajnu wa yubahi malaikata. Allah azza wa jal, He boasts in front of His angels. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way it is appropriate to Him, He descends to the first heaven. And Allah azza wa jal, He forgives so many millions and millions of people. This is why, respected brothers and sisters, we should take heed from the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So people who are not in Arafah, you know, millions of people, they couldn't make it there. So are we going to get the mercy of Allah as well? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to forgive us as well? Yes, inshaAllah ta'ala, provided that we also do the good deeds, al-a'mal al-saliha. Two specific good deeds that I would like to mention in front of you today. Number one is that, inshaAllah ta'ala, if you get the tawfiq to fast on the day of Arafah, fast on the day of Arafah. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the person who fasts on the day of Arafah, أَحْتَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَيُكَفِّرَ السَّنَةَ الَّتِي قَبْلَ وَالَّتِي بَعْدَ, that it will become the compensation for all your sins, the sins of the past year and the coming year. So inshallah ta'ala, if you could fast, then go ahead. It's very virtuous. The second deed is very important, is takbir. From the day of Arafah, from the fajr of Arafah, then everyone should recite the following takbir after each salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. And this should continue on the fajr of, from the fajr of Arafah, that on the 10th, on the 11th, on the 12th, up to the asr of 13. So that becomes 23 salah. 5, 10, 15, 20, 23 salah. This is called takbir muqayyad, specific takbir. Similarly, there's something called takbir mutlaq, which should be any time. Okay, general takbir, something that the people are avoiding. People are waiting for the Arafah day. No, we're supposed to be every time. Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala used to go to the market, he used to go to visit his friends, and whenever he's going to the masjid, he's always reciting Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. And this general takbir starts from the very first day of Dhul Hijjah. From the first day to the 10th, from the first day, and you continue every time until the Arafah day starts, then obviously you will increase your takbir even after Salah. Remember one thing, after Salah, from the Fajr of Arafah is essential for male and female to recite the takbir at least once after the first Salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to celebrate this day of Arafah with good deeds, with fasting and with dhikr, with tahleel, with tasbih, with taqdis. InshaAllah ta'ala, make dua for yourself, make dua for your family and friends, but don't forget also the entire Muslim ummah. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us the tawfiq to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah.